Hi and welcome Aquarius, Rose Burnett here and this is your mid-month tarot forecast for July 2023. It is a general reading, so always trust yourself what resonates, leave what does not. Big welcome to those that are new to my channel, those that follow me regularly, rockin' awesome, love your support. If you enjoy my videos, make sure to subscribe to my channel, hit that notification bell so my videos come through to you in your feed and you join our community. Now there is a competition running again this month, so if you want to go into the draw to win the beautiful angel reading cards, all you need to do is subscribe to my channel, pop a comment down below you want to win this deck, you'll go into the draw. There's also a personal reading up for grabs, so it's a 45-minute pre-recorded personal reading with me. And I'll be looking for a very positive community member. Also, below any of my videos this month, make sure to let me know in the comments down below you want to win that personal reading and you'll go into the draw. All right, let's dive in. So we're going to pull you an opening energy from the beautiful Heart and Soul Oracle. And let's see what you need to know, Aquarius. She kind of looks like she's a tree. She's kind of swaying in the breeze there. It says you're entering a deeply emotional time in which you ponder the deeper spiritual questions of life. It is a time of self-discovery and deepens your connection to Mother Earth, your friends and family. At times your emotions may overflow, but this is a good thing. These precious moments bring a gift of healing. Well, that's kind of beautiful. All right, let's have a look at your spiritual guidance. So we're going to be pulling some guidance from the Star Temple Oracle. I would just mention you can get all of my free astrology readings, my inspirational videos on my Spotify podcast in both audio and video. If you're on Spotify, you can listen wherever you go. Oh, wow. This is so in tune with the central energy that just came out. You've pulled the amber star. Now, if I bring that really closely, she's actually got an amber stone at the back of the sacral chakra. It's all about letting go. I surrender and allow myself to grieve. So some of you may have physically lost someone from your world. You may have lost a relationship. There may have been something disappointing that you need to let go of. Versus shoving down and ignoring. Oh, yeah, because it's followed by the morning star. Lots of gold energy coming out. All about radiance. I shoot for the stars. Radiance is my birthright. So when you go through this process, it's going to help you elevate and rise. Whatever you've been going through that's a little bit challenging is there to strengthen you when you come out the other side of it. Yeah. You've also pulled the sacred orchard, which is all about co-creation. She's holding a beautiful golden apple in her hand. It says, my abundance mindset attracts endless blessings. So being in that state of positivity to attract your abundance to you. Oh, wow. You've also pulled beloved Zeus, which is all about the lovers, a cosmic union destined for greatness. So you're either with a true love, soulmate connection, or there's one coming towards you. All right, let's have a look at four key areas of focus for you with the Sacred Destiny Oracle for the second half of July. Oh, you've got stillness. So in spirit saying, take some quiet time out in stillness to allow yourself to let go. It's directly related to surrendering and grieving. You've also got pleasure here. So there's beautiful nature here. It's directly related to your abundance. Wow. And you're manifesting miracles in your life right now. The Spirit's saying you've got to see the truth in any storms. Don't ignore it. Don't push it down. Don't leave it for another day to sort out. All right, let's put some clarifiers with the energy oracle. First up, let's have a look at you allowing yourself to let go of things and taking some quiet time out for self. You got your solar plexus chakra here. So there's a need for you to boost up your physical energy, or you, if you've been unwell, you're coming back into a place of more energy and vitality. You've got a man holding his heart here, so there's certainly a love interest here. Guys, you might be releasing something to open up to love. Yeah, there's absolutely things you need to walk away from and let go of. Some of you got a contract coming in, so you may be leaving a job behind that you've been in a long time. It's number six, which is related to abundance and love. You may be breaking a marriage contract for some of you. Mm-hmm. You've already broken it. There may be something that you're going through in the legal system. All right, let's have a look at you coming out of this bit of storm that's gone on and shooting for the stars. Well, you've got community here, so lean on your friendships. Don't isolate yourself too much. Number of sevens, part of your healing journey is connecting with your friendships. Oh yeah, here we go. You've got cornucopia coming in, success on every level. Joy, happiness, love, abundance, good health, wealth, abundance. Again, I'm gonna say abundance, abundance. You've got this gorgeous, happy family around you. Mm-hmm. Whatever family means to you. Yeah, you absolutely need to take some time out with for rest and relaxation. So balancing doing with resting. All right, let's have a look at your abundance mindset here and taking some time out and pleasure. You're absolutely got your coin coming in, girls. Security, stability. Some of you actively working on your coin. There's lots of doors you can open, lots of opportunities that are going to come your way related to your cornucopia. Spirit saying you're going to have victory. Victory over the past, victory over any states of lack, but you've got to walk away from things that don't serve you any longer. You've got woman holding a coin, man holding a coin, both genders here, both coming into your financial security and stability. All right, let's have a look at your miracle happening over here, this divine love, and you seeing the truth in any storm happening in your life. You've got to trust your intuition, Spirit saying, about any storms. People being passive-aggressive, things you need to sort out. And you've got the temple path. Spirit's watching over you. Absolutely watching over you. Okay, you've got some indecision here. Do I go left? Do I go right? We'll explore that. And you've got the door to personal healing and happiness opening. Some of you working on your healing. There's certainly some heart chakra healing that needs to happen, or you're around your emotions. And everything needs to be in balance, Spirit saying. So you've got to work on your inner peace and balance, your emotional balance, physical balance. Yeah, because again, you've got a storm going off here. It's related to healing and happiness. All right, what's this indecision here about? Okay, it's about you holding yourself back in life, feeling stuck in some aspect of your life is where you're going to need to apply the healing and release. For some of you, it's related to your throat chakra. So speaking your truth, speaking up for self. Okay, for others, it's around people being envious of you or you feeling like you're in a state of lack. Any other guidance there? You got the door to romance opening. So some of you are worrying that you're not going to find another love, and you will, because the door's opening. There's a divine pair here. Mm-hmm. Let's have a look at this storm warning. Okay, yeah. All right, my loves. It's related to your root chakra, your finances, your sense of security and stability, and it's also related to your emotions. What you're going through, what you're saying to yourself. All right, let's pull you some guidance from the Goddess Guidance deck. Having a look at this top row, which is all about you letting go of things and walking away from them. You've got a contract here, you've got your energy here, you got a man holding a heart in his hands. Oh, darlings, you've absolutely got abundance and prosperity coming in. You've got to believe in it. It's coming. This contract could be bringing abundance in. You just got to stay strong right now. Mm-hmm. Keep moving forward. Maintain your center. Absolute confirmation from the universe. You've got material wealth coming in and your emotions are also going to be met. So that means love, connection, friendships, family. Mm-hmm. Going to be supplied for today and all of you tomorrow. So stop worrying, Spirit's saying. Let's have a look at this second row here where you're coming out of the ashes and shooting for the stars. You've got your cornucopia here, your happy family, taking some rest, your friendships. Oh, everything's leading you to peace. Spirit's saying you just got to stop worrying so much. Perfect time to kick off any new ideas and projects that you have that you want to start. And Spirit's saying one of the ways in which you're going to balance yourself is to get yourself outside in nature and those feet on Mother Earth. All right, let's have a look at you attracting your abundance. There's both genders here holding their coin in their hand. You having victory. Yeah, you got Coventina purification. You need to do a cleanse and a detox. Physical body, emotions, mindset. Your independence is an integral part of who you are, so it's part of your key strength to rely on that independence and your strength. And you're the magician in your own life. This is the sorceress deck here. You've got everything you need to create the life you want to create. All right, let's have a look at this side, which is certainly love happening. You've got to see the truth in storms, which is mostly around yourself. Yep. Fear, worry, anxiety going on unnecessarily. All right. I can feel your energy right now. So some of you need to take the right hand, I know we're opposite, put it over the center of the chest, the heart chakra. Feel the warmth of the hand and just feel the comfort there and just relax. Okay, relax. Feel a lot better. Keep it there if you like while we do your reading. You got green Tara, start delegating. So ask others for help if you need it. And there's a focus on your home right now. So you're possibly moving home, relocating, doing your home up, buying, selling. Spirit saying you just got to take a leap of faith and go after what it is you want. All right, let's put you some guidance from the crystal healing deck. Have a look at this top row, all about your blessings coming in. You need to walk away from things and let them go. Oh, you're divinely protected at this time by a spirit, and you've just got to step into your empowerment, your personal power. Big focus on your life purpose here. So keep focusing on that, your passions, your purpose. Oh, you need to put healthy boundaries in place with people. So that's part of your life lesson there. And you focus on your creativity. Oh, wow. Your ancestors are absolutely watching over you right now. And they're sending blessings of abundance to you. So that is, you've got a miracle sitting here. You've got two confirmations that you've got abundance coming in. Let me hold them up. I'll just drop that one. You've also got a contract sitting there. Hello, darlings. As well as a man holding a coin, woman holding a coin. Keep the faith. Keep the faith, my loves. Double abundance confirmation coming through. Amazing. They want me to pull one more there. Oh, two more. Again, you've got the message that there's going to be a renewal of peace in your world. You've pulled peace twice and two messages to get your feet on Mother Earth to deal with the anxiety and worry going on right now that you need to release. All right, let's pull you some guidance from the messenger oracle. Spirit's saying you were born to create. Trust in your ideas. There's a dragon there holding a big golden egg with light emitting out of it. And to trust in magic, that the universe is going to help you. Spirit's going to help you. Yeah, you just need to wash away your burdens and release them. Yeah, I was going to say this. Let the emotions flow. Have a good cry if you need to. Let it out, Aquarius. Oh, on the bottom of the deck, you've got be without malice. So whoever you're dealing with that has created any kind of turmoil in your life is you be the bigger person. Don't get stuck in their energy, any negative energy, don't get stuck in it. Don't retaliate. Rise above it, darlings, rise above it. All right, let's have a look at your abundance flows. Oh, you're getting a raise or promotion coming in. Hello, for your hard work. It's on its way. Mm-hmm. Some of you are going through an employment change. Hello, could be what the contract is. Yes. And obstacles and blockages are being lifted out of your path, darlings. Does it get any better? Oh. On the bottom of the deck, you've got seven vows of poverty. So those of you in scarcity consciousness, you need to let that go because your blessings are coming in. All right, let's have a look at your chakra balance, which mostly your root chakra and your sacral chakra is out of whack. Yes. Oh, here it is, your root chakra. Massive focus on your sense of security and stability right now. Give yourself a hug. Tell yourself you love yourself. You've got to be in your crown chakra, darlings, your higher states of consciousness. And you need to cleanse the emotional body. Oh, big time. Do some guided meditations. Do a sound therapy class at least once a week for the next 4 weeks if you can get hold of one. Uh-huh. Cleanse, cleanse, cleanse. Right, let's have a look at your connection to spirit, divine gifts and talents. Well, spirit saying naturopathy would be good for you. It could also be a path you want to follow. Oh, Mother Earth has come out again. It's come out three times. And you're connected to the ancient soul tribe. So you've got a lot of ancient wisdom within you. All right, let's have a look at your life path guidance. Oh, you like working with people, so you quite enjoy it. When you love running with your ideas, so whatever you do, you're going to need some autonomy. So even though you like working with people, you may want to be more in a leadership role or something where you have that flexibility to run with your ideas, because otherwise you're going to feel stifled. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because some of you got the spirit of an entrepreneur. So recognize that within self. All right, let's pull you some guidance in terms of from your angels. Oh, darlings, you got the message that you're protected. Again, you are safe. Do not fear. We are always with you and surround you with our invisible wings of light. Your angels are absolutely watching over you. All right, let's pull your crowning energy from the beautiful Pegasus Oracle. Gorgeous deck by Lana Fairchild. What is it Aquarius needs to know at this time? Thank you. Oh, wow. Wow, wow. Wait till you see it. You've pulled the Pegasus of the Black Diamond. So gorgeous. Let's pull you up the guidance. It says, Aquarius, Pegasus, guardian of the soul, connects you with your inner spiritual authority. You are laying claim to your strength, your dignity, your self-confidence, and self-respect. Your soul has a genius capable of transforming any tragedy into a triumph of spirit. Such alchemy arises from suffering that burns away attachments and self-limiting identities, emptying us so that our souls naturally activate and attract spiritual deliverance. Pegasus is your guide, helping you shift from hopelessness to confidence and healing. And Pegasus of the Black Diamond speaks of the profound wisdom and strength you have gained through your encounters with the darker side of human nature. Your soul growth has been hard won, but it cannot be undone. Negativity may rise within or around you, but it will never overcome you. Within this sign of tremendous growth and awakening, you're being asked to recognize your spiritual strength. Allow your inner knowing to ease any concern that has temporarily confused your heart. The spiritual worlds offer gratitude and acknowledgement for all that you are and do. You deserve whatever you wish to ask of the universe, so pray with conviction that your prayers will be answered with grace and kindness. A time of difficulty, a cycle of challenging karma is now complete. You have crossed a permanent threshold into grace. Allow your mind to catch up with your spirit and you shall experience deep, abiding peace. Oh my God. Amazing. Amazing, amazing. So comforting, darlings, about what you've gone through. All right, those are your messages. Love to hear your feedback, your comments down below on how it resonated with you. Reach out for a personal reading if you feel like you need extra guidance and support at this time. I have just opened up 30-minute readings, which allow you to focus on just one aspect of your life that you want guidance on, or you can also get the extended reading with me. Booking link is on here and down below. All right, my loves for now. Much love, much light. Namaste.